I'm Corvin Lord Hayes, and this is How to Be an Artist. To be an artist, you only need a few things. In particular, you need something to work with. You can use basically anything. The world is your canvas. And apparently, all you have to do to make any kind of work of art is take what's already there and tweak it just a little bit. But you know, you can tweak it a lot. You can come up with things that you've never seen anywhere else before. And if you're asking yourself the question, am I really an artist? Are you Corvin Lord Hayes? Absolutely, Corvin Lord Hayes. Absolutely, Corvin Lord Hayes. I am definitely an artist. Well, how do you know that? Well, if you're watching this video, either you have an obsession with artists, a mild interest in artists, or you are an artist. So, which is it? We're all friends here. I'm not gonna lie to you. I don't expect you to lie to me. You are an artist. We all are. Of course we are, duh. You feel things in a way that other people don't express. They don't tell you in their text messages. They don't tell you on their videos. They don't tell you over the phone. There is you, and then there is the rest of the world. And the only place that you see and feel this sensation is within your own being. And we want to get it out as artists. Now, there's a lot of hearsay and whoop-de-doo attached to the word artist. An artist is special. An artist is weird. An artist is interesting. All of these things can be true if they apply to certain individuals from the perspective of another individual, sure. But what do they mean to you? What do they mean to me? As an artist, it is the right thing to do to get this feeling out of me in some kind of way. Now, I can do it by robbing a bank. You know, I could do it by robbing the Dixie Mart. I could do it by walking down the road and pissing on an air conditioner. Sure, I could, but as an artist, I'm a little bit more vain than that. I don't know if you are. Every artist has their quirks. We're all a little bit different. We're all a little bit strange compared to one another. But me, my ego is just a little bit on the edge of, whoa, that's too much. As an artist, it is my duty, my sworn protectors swear, that I am to lay down these feelings I have in some form of expression so that I can look on at what it is and instead of having a distorted view of what I feel, I have a new perspective on what it is that I actually feel, because 10 times out of 10, what I think I feel is not what it turns out to be, what I'm actually feeling after I put down this work of art and I look at it. Because your view will always be changing. Your perception will always shift. And as you lay down this creation an expression of how you feel about the world around you and within. You shift, and you will never be the same. As an artist and a super hot pepper gardener and a noise musician and rock musician and whatever else I can't remember at the moment, spray paint artist. And you know, when I don't lay down these feelings, they just keep building up. You know, and everybody thinks of being an artist is such a superficial thing, so superfluous. It means nothing. Art is so entirely useless, they say. Well, sure, you know, it's useless for you, except that because I've made this work of art, now I don't feel like going totally fucking insane. And you know, even the other day, I had this sensation that I wanted to partake in things that I really know I shouldn't. I wanted it. Oh, I wanted it. And I imagined for a moment, what if I created something to express this feeling? And you know, I got an idea. I started thinking about it, and I followed it in little ways. Like something special, sweet. Walking swiftly away from me down a hallway of infinite doors. And I could keep on running after it. Then I woke back up and realized I was sitting on the driveway. Talking to my wife, and I told her, I said, you know, I was thinking about partaking in things that I really shouldn't, and then I thought about what it would be like if I made something to represent this feeling. I told her, I felt better, but then the feeling creeps back in again. What do I do? It's simple, Corvin Lord Hayes. There is only one thing to do. In one hand, you can whine and twist and moan, yelp and cry. And on the other hand, you can seize that feeling. Wrap your hand right around it. Squeeze the seeds out of it. And they plop onto the ground in a viscous, wet pulp. And if you want to, you can get some water. Stay hydrated. And then hydrate those seeds. Those beginning flickers of thought. Those little twists of ideas. You can cultivate those. You get them all the time, so do I. Don't lie to yourself. You know I know when you're lying, right? David Lynch gets them all the time. Marilyn Manson gets them all the time. Johnny Depp probably gets them all the time. I don't fucking know, but I promise you, as an artist, my solemn, swearedly, honesty, goodness, if you take one of these ideas and you cultivate it, you propagate it, set it in water and let it grow roots, you will not feel the same about whatever it was that this idea was about. As an artist, it is my solemn duty to create so that I don't go fucking crazy. I seem to recall David Bowie saying something like that. Maybe not so blunt. But he said, creating was what, like, I don't know the words he used. It kept him standing tall, kept him feeling straight. He wasn't straight, but but even I get a little tickle in the pants looking at some pretty guys, you know. Not that I want to tickle anything in the pants, except, being an artist is all about feeling different about the world than what you see elsewhere. Corporations and businesses, and maybe even other artists that say they are the top. And you are the bottom because you haven't made it up to the top yet. They say there is a way to do it. They say there's a thing to do. And part of what that thing is you have to compromise. I just don't fucking like that word. And I want you to know that it's not your fault that you are this way. The spirit of an artist is unhindered, untethered. That's why everybody looks at you and they say, what are you doing? Or they say, no, you're not. In the heat of a moment of passion and excitement, you tell somebody, some part of yourself that you feel deeply. And what do they say? Something or other about how you aren't right. And that their intellectual beliefs are somehow stronger and less strange than the way you feel as a person that stands before them. Well, maybe I don't fucking like that you wear blue jeans. You might think that it matters what mama or pop says, or what your sister thinks, or what little brother says of you. You might think it matters, but it doesn't. Because we're all bullshitters. And all we do is bullshit. I stand here before you with an idea that came to me in my sleep, and it just made my soul feel like soaring, and I had to share it with you. That's what everybody says all the time. That's all we ever do. And if it's not that, it's something like this. These people, they did that thing that I didn't like, and I see all these people doing these things that I don't like, and I don't like it at all, and I want everybody to stop because I don't like it. And that's not right, is it? The world is an icky, strange, and dicky place. It really is. Some people can't stand the sight of the color black, and others love the color red. I'm not really fond of any colors except the range of color that I see on a day-to-day basis. I like that, Generally speaking, I don't really like any one color more than the next. I do love to see that dark, stark shade of goddamn green on my pepper plants. I love that. And every once in a while, when I'm driving my wife home from college, I get to see the sunset. It's incredible magenta and pink and orange. It's blazing red, fire-like color streaking across the sky. But I guess you know what? My favorite part of that color is the fuchsia. I like that the most. But none of that fuchsia would mean anything if it wasn't for all the other colors that came with it. And just like all of these people that don't like the way you do things, their life means absolutely nothing if you weren't there. I mean, you know, it might mean absolutely nothing, you know, even if you weren't there, you know, even if you were there, it doesn't mean anything, I mean, maybe. But, you know, their lives are not what's at stake here, is it? It's our lives. They're the people who have given up on the fact that they could be artists. They just don't have that feeling in them. They don't have that tickle. That sweetness. That sour seed in their chest. That, you know, maybe you and I, we just want to tear it out. Crush it in our hands and sprinkle it on a fucking taco salad. And then maybe we might feel better. Being an artist is a paradox. Because we have all these feelings. But we don't want to get rid of all of them. Because there's something about it we like. We like being different. Maybe you don't. I'm sorry. I do. Boy, gee, golly, gosh, good goddamn, I would not want to be like some of these other boring motherfuckers walking the streets. Jesus Christ. No. I don't want to be normal. And if I was, I'd be afraid to wonder what I would think about the world. Because I know, I look at everything and I don't like any of it. I see everything. Everything that I see, I love to do it different. But of course, there's always going to be those people that don't like the way you do things. And you can shrug and shrivel and wade at the bottom of your shallow pool. You could. And you might just drown there, but... And you know, even if you get up out of that pool and you go to walk towards the ocean, you're still gonna have people walking down the beach and say, I don't like your swim trunks. But they say, the way your face is shaped looks funny and it makes me laugh and think about how much I love my life. But I'm actually just lying because I'm just looking for something to feel better about. And you'll have to figure out something to say to this person. Or you'll have to figure out how you're going to stand when they say that to you. You know, how do I want people to see my eyes? What do I want people to see in my eyes when they look at me? When they say, boy, you ought to get that haircut, and I think, you know, I'd love to, but I'm a busy man, and I got business to tend to. You know what I want to see in my eyes? You know what I want people to see when they look me in my eyes? You know what I want to see? I want people to see that I don't give a fuck what they think, but I'm willing to listen to what they have to say. If it's not anything I'm interested in, I'm gonna walk away. But don't make the mistake of thinking I'm not paying attention to where you stand. Because I do. I'm very aware of my surroundings. But that's not the point, is it? I hope. I hope this video's taught you something. I hope it sheds some kind of meaning onto your life. And if you got the feeling in you to create something, don't let it go. Don't. Because it's going to creep up in on you and it's going to hurt you. And that's why when you look at these normal people that all they do, they go to their jobs and they work for that money so that they can pay for their kids' tuition or whatever the piss. All they do is work, and they come home and they play Scrabble or tic-tac-toe or bingo and watch Seinfeld. And there's nothing wrong with Seinfeld. But, and there's nothing wrong with you if you like Seinfeld. But you know, some people, they get lost. And once you get lost, it's very easy to get locked into something. I've learned over these past few years, 5, 10, 15, 20, 8 years, I've learned that you can be addicted to anything, and if something works in some kind of way, if I do this action over and over and over again, I get paid, and everything's okay, and then I don't have to worry about anything, even though I have all these other feelings in me that are dying to get out, feel like claws inside my chest. But it's okay, because my kids are alright. They come and they watch TV, we play games, do their homework. We talk about Mr. Potato Head. I buy them Hungry Hungry Hippos, and they play it until the cows come home. And then the next day, we start all over again. And you know, maybe it'll take you till you're 53, 62 years old, where you realized there was more you wanted to do with your life. There is no difference between a hobbyist and an artist. That feeling is the same. It's almost like obsession. Obsessive people are artists. Scientists are artists. Whatever it is that you got this feeling that you want to explore and check out, you should. But I want you to remember something. If exploring this thing means taking candy out of somebody else's pocket, maybe you should think about it a little more. Very dangerous thing to say. But this isn't my life. It's yours.